Hello there. Do you still know me? Let me take off my sunglasses. It is me, Koplamp. Yes, I'm still here. And today I'm going to the ATT, the ATT, or I don't know how to pronounce it in English actually, the astronomy fair. Yeah, I remember that in my last video I was also looking and struggling for the correct word for it. Well, I'm going to the astronomy fair in Essen, Germany. So I hope I can create a nice video for you all, so you get to see what kind of vendors are there, what kind of products are there, perhaps some new stuff. I think ZWO is even there for the first time, and it's the 40th anniversary, basically, for this Astronomy und Technik Treff. I think that's what ATT stands for. So, I'm going to drive there. Will take me about 1.5 hours or so. So I'll see you there. The ATT is divided into two parts. In the big halls you'll find the vendors and big names in astronomy. But we'll start in the classrooms and hallways of the Am Stoppenberg Gymnasium. There you'll find the second-hand market, with the opportunity to find lots of books, astronomy-related organizations, binoculars, classic scopes, and the occasional custom builds that talented hobbyists have created. I even met a fellow YouTuber here. Hey, Mario Marcaro, also known as Astroino, and his German channel Make Astronomy. The Eiffel area is praised for being the perfect spot to go stargazing. Guess where I'll be going on holiday this summer. There are also some creative self-built solutions. No idea what all these knobs are for. I owned this exact type of telescope and it ran on a 9-volt battery. Another thing that stood out to me was this huge binocular setup consisting out of two Fixen AS 120mm refractors. An intriguing contraption made the eyepieces both have the same focal length. Somebody here is well versed in machining aluminium, or aluminum for those across the Atlantic. Another impressive feat is this pair of harmonic mounts. I think they are self-built with a 3D printed encasing. Markus Haller, if you're watching, feel free to leave a comment below with some links. And somebody apparently had a photo bag for sale. I just bought one, new. Pretty similar to this one actually. Okay, let's go to the main halls where we'll find the telescope vendors. The first vendor you'll see at the main entrance is Berlebach with their wooden tripods. And another regular visitor to the ATT are the droid builders Germany with Star Trek and Star Wars related models, such as these two remote controlled R2-D2s. In the first big hall, Bader Planetarium has taken residence. They show off their range of filters, adapters and huge telescopes on huge mounts who are all waving around the mounted telescopes as if they weigh nothing. The yellow submarine telescope was impressive to see, although I would get rid of that weird contraption with all those eyepieces and add a camera. This should be a great planetary scope. Around this first hall there were stalls which sold meteorites, some more advertising for astro travels. And the Celestron booth. Although an announcement said that the new RASA 6 would also be on display, I only saw the 14-inch Edge HD. An 11-inch RASA and an 8-inch RASA with an odd choice of camera. When we move from the first hall to the second hall, you'll find more vendors. Again, some regular ones I saw in previous editions too. Such as the Koplamp sales guy. Telescope Service had a big booth with lots of scopes for sale, among which a huge RC telescope. It was quite busy in this hall, where you could find suppliers of remote services, but also astroshop.de, which sold, among other stuff, plush toys of planets, comets and other astronomy related topics. They of course also had telescopes for sale. One of the new suppliers on the show was Proxy Sky, who make harmonic mounts. They come in a sturdy case and they come with a lot of nice features, such as an optional power and USB hub built into the saddle of the mount. And also new on the ATT was ZWO, who were showing off some of their new stuff, such as the C-Star smart telescopes. Their range of cameras with an ASIR built into them. And the EAF Pro. Time for a break. Luckily, there was plenty of cake available at good prices. Let's now go to the downstairs area in Hall 3, But first let's go check out the outside space, as there usually are plenty of solar scopes on display there. Unfortunately, this year there were only a couple. Also outside was an Explore Scientific candy car, at least for those doing visual astronomy, with lots and lots of eyepieces, one of which was huge, almost 2.5 kilos of eyepiece, with a 3-inch barrel. The Am Stoppenberg Gymnasium also has a roof terrace where a few other solid scopes were in use. But let's get back inside again. In hall 3 we find Bresser, with lots of different types of telescopes, among which a huge Dobsonian. And also in hall 3, like the years before, Ganymedes. Always a joy to meet them.
Hello!
They always bring the nicest candy. And I even spotted ZWO giving them some presents. All in all, a nice ATT again.